Good evening and welcome to this evening's equity market wrap. And my name is Lisa Pallavi Barbara. What a splendid day for the market it was today. And of course, this is in reaction to the US Federal Reserve saying that it will not taper its quantitative easing program. More than that, the Federal Reserve governor sounded very subdued when talking about the job growth data in the US, which is lower than expected, and also the overall economic growth data, which is also lower than expected. Hence, experts suggest that the tapering may not come anytime soon and not by a very big quantum. So this brought a lot of joy to equity markets, especially emerging equities. The back home domestic benchmark indices rallied as much as 4% in intraday trade and finally settled around 3.5% high. Now that's quite a rally, maybe the second largest in the Asian emerging market pack after Jakarta, which also rallied quite a lot. Now the rally was not limited to equities. The other assets, fixed income, and the rupee markets also participated a lot. So the Indian rupee finally finished around 61.78, the highest level since around a month. If you look at the 10-year G-Sec yield, that moved up sharply to around 8.2%, much higher than the 8.5 levels it was trading at in the last few days. So really all assets rejoiced the news from the US Federal Reserve. Coming back to equities, the BSE Sensex finally finished at 20,646 and the Nifty closed at 6,115, the highest level since November 2010. Now, mid-cap stocks did participate in the rally, but really the spotlight was on large caps today. If you look at sectoral indices, clearly it was the rate sensitives which rallied the most. Banking stocks, which were the most beaten down in the recent months, are the ones which gained the maximum. So the BankEx was up around 6.78%. Now that's a huge rally, but one stock deserves mention, which is Yes Bank, which rallied as much as 24% in intraday trade before settling around 22.5% higher. But that stock also had corrected from levels of 500 earlier in the year to around 220, 230 in August. So it did see a big fall, but now the rise up has been as fast as well. The Realty Index also gained sharply, up around 5.3%. There weren't any declining indices today, but IT stocks didn't perform, so the IT index was quite flat. If you look at mid-cap IT stocks, there were actually declines in that segment. So Hexaware was down around 0.2%, Mindtree was down around 3.5%, NIIT Technologies was down around 1.5%. Even among large-cap ITs, the news was not very good. Wipro was down around 1.9%, HCL Tech was down around 0.8%, whereas TCS and Infosys were pretty much flat. So there were some declining names in trade today. Another segment which didn't do well were jewelry stocks. Gitanjali Gems was down another 5%. There, of course, corporate governance issues were also at play. And then there was PC Jewelers, which was down around 0.2% today. So there were some declining stocks despite the exuberance in the market today. Coming back to the Sensex names, it was banking and metals at the top. SBI was up around 8%. Tata Steel gained around 7%. Then there was ICICI Bank, Tata Power, which were up around 6.5%. Among Sensex names, the only real declining stock was Wipro, down around 1.9%. Now, experts are divided on whether this rally will continue like this. Some say markets have moved ahead of fundamentals and one should book profits. Others say that the mood is good and one should remain invested. So we don't really know which way the markets might head from here. Nevertheless, tomorrow is another important day with the RBI's credit policy meeting. So we'll have to wait and see how any steps are taken in that meeting and how that might impact the equity markets. That's all from me. Do log on to liveman.com for more details. Thank you.